In many remote Alaskan communities, it can be a challenge to get an accurate count for the U.S. Census.
We're way out here in the coast.
What can be done to ensure that people's personal data is not only counted accurately, but is also protected?
Especially today with malicious actors all around the world trying to get at people's data.
Along the southwest coast of Alaska, by the Bering Sea is Nunakoyak, also known in English as Toksook Bay. In 2020, the U.S. Census counted roughly 656 people are living here.
So Toksook Bay is located on an island we call Kaluyak.
It's home to Charlene Bosco, the dean of students at Nelson Island School. It's home to James Cipri, an elder and a mentor to teens who are coming of age.
This village used to be a fishing camp, and my grandfather's camp, winter and summer, for the survival of his families.
And today, Yupik residents here still use hunting and fishing as their way of survival.
Get the rest of the stuff.
It's one of the reasons why the U.S. Census is important. The data that is collected from the survey can help determine budgets and benefits when subsistence falls short.
Each year, each community gets a certain amount of money from the state of Alaska. They use our population estimates, and so if we have a bad input for the decennial census, that bad data will be there for the entire decade. The only way we are able to get an accurate picture of that is every 10 years.
As state demographer David Howell explains, remote has a different meaning in Alaska.
These places are not on the road system most of the time. You're flying in or boating in. Rivers become highways for snow machines.
For the first time in 2020, the U.S. Census offered an option for residents to submit their survey online or by mail.
All census responses are completely confidential.
But after scientists ran a hypothetical attack on the 2010 census, a new problem arose, which was protection.
A scenario in which, if this data was stolen from the Bureau, how many records could you match to the actual population? And so they were able to match quite a high number.
Records that carry personal information, such as your name, gender, your age, and address.
That's when they decided to implement differential privacy.
Differential privacy is an approach that preserves the big picture statistics data of a group while protecting the specific private information about individuals in that group. So how does it work? The method they use intentionally alters the data set by adding or subtracting from the actual count in order to obscure individual identities, making it so that even if hackers cross-reference other data sets, they still won't be able to figure out specific information about those individuals. It's kind of like if we took a picture of the Yupik dance group. We can see facial features and identities that could be exposed. But with added noise, the algorithm might blur a few faces slightly or add static to the overall photo, lowering the quality enough so that the overall picture is still intact, while protecting everyone's personal identities in this photo.
Differential privacy had a larger impact the smaller the population was.
Besides multiple delays on delivering age and gender statistics, Howell says that the algorithm altered population numbers between 5 and 10%, which seems like a small amount for most cities in the U.S. But compared to a town the size of Toksook Bay, adding those alterations can create more than errors within a data set.
Back to grants, if your population is off, you may not get approved for such a thing. Well, with these grants, they're able to build more homes for people, build community centers.
Out here, a home itself is hard to get. We still have young adults with parents under their roof.
Accurate data might lead to more job opportunities for those who are graduating high school.
The very important things that I would like to see is the native workforce development. Prepare our people for their future as we journey on forward to win for life.
The census plans on using differential privacy for 2030, but the challenge still remains, preserving the balance of accuracy and security.